In this video, I'm going to show you how I make candles. Starting out with glass votive holders, I'm putting in the wicks. Then I have several candle holders set up, ready to be poured. I have to put sticks on the top to center the wicks. I use soy wax flakes and shea butter in addition to lavender oil. When that's all melted, then my wax is ready to pour. I can start pouring into my votive candle holders. I usually leave an extra amount of wax at the end so that I can top off each of the candles if they're not quite up to the same level. This process can get fairly messy, as you can see in the picture. Fortunately, any of the wax that drips onto the sheet, the cookie sheet there, I can scoop it up after it dries and use it again, remelt it back down. Spill quite a bit there. And that's what the candles are going to look like when they're done, except for have to wipe off the wax that gets on the outside of the votive holder. The candles themselves will be a little bit whiter right now. That's melted, and they kind of have a yellowish appearance from the shea butter additive. So here they are cooling. Here are the labels that I use to put on the bottoms. These are warning labels. And I have to cut each one of these out individually with a little cutter device. And perhaps the hardest thing that I have to do is to try and get the backing off of the labels. It's kind of hard to get off each one of these little round labels. And I'm making a total of 100 candles for this order. So this takes a while. So then that goes on the bottom of the candle. And these are the candles that are ready to be stickered. And then they're going to have a label on the front. I box them up. I have 12 candles in a box. And there you have it. Those are my candles. I make several different scents, including vanilla, cinnamon, Kahlua, Cabernet, lavender, amaretto, citrus, cherry, anything you want.